Hello everyone, it's ZeroGuardian back for another episode of ZeroGuardian Plays Through His Steam Library. Today I am playing Deponia, The Complete Journey. This is a point-and-click adventure game, similar in style to like Machinarium and for those who are really old school, like the old original like Myst and stuff like that, where like you click around the world to to travel and move your character. This one, rather than like Myst, it's more like Machinarium in the sense that it's a bunch of like 2D pictures and so forth, and cartoon-esque characters that kind of move around the map, and so you'll interact with objects, solve puzzles, talk to NPC characters to continue the story and everything. And now I've never played this game, like just like any of the other games in this series. I just know a lot of that from just watching some videos and doing a little bit of research ahead of time just to make sure I'm prepared and ready to go. That way I'm not too surprised by the game or controls and stuff like that. Plus, I'm sure the game would be really boring if, I just started, mentioning or had to learn, like, everything about the game, before you jumped in. But, or even jumped in without knowing anything. That could be, might be interesting, but probably not. Anyways, I'm rambling. Let's stop. As always, I will be doing these Monday and Wednesday at 7 p.m. This past Monday, I played L.A. Noire. It's a fantastic detective third-person game made by Rockstar. I highly encourage you to go watch the video. It was a lot of fun. Obviously today I'm playing Deponia, and then I also be doing these every Friday at 2 p.m. This Friday I'm going to be playing Cube, or Quick Understanding of Block Extrusion, which is a first-person puzzle game where you do a lot of interaction with the world and so forth. Really looking forward to that as well, so feel free and join me then. I'm also doing this in part as kind of a project of a side project of mine. Also doing it on our as part of kind of a campaign on our forums. So feel free to join us on the forums. That's forums.spacepotatoes.com. Feel free to join us. We have a regularly scheduled game night every Friday. This Friday we're going to be playing Demigod. We're actually in the process of voting for our games for next month. So if you join the forums now, you might be able to put in your input on what games we play next month. And of course you can always just join us for good food or good games, good discussion. Everybody there is a gamer, mostly casual, not a lot of hardcore gamers. If that's kind of your thing, or you're just looking for a group of people that you can kind of interact with without having to deal with a bunch of hardcore crazy gamers, this is like the perfect community for you. As with any of my videos in the past, I've always wanted to show you the settings in the game so you can kind of get an idea of what kind of configuration options are in here. Now, a game like this isn't going to have as many as, a 3D game. It'll have a lot of graphics options and so forth. So as you can see here, there's not a lot of graphics options. You can do windowed mode, full screen, change your resolutions, and then change the animation details, stuff like that. But what it does have a decent job of is the sound. So you can choose the spoken language in the game, what the volume is on that, the music, the effects, any videos that are played during the game, and then the overall sound volume. So it's nice to see in a game here where there's not a whole lot of, and I don't want developers' commentary right now, or there's not a whole lot of graphics options. It's nice to see that they did a decent job of making the sound options pretty good in the game. So I think I'm actually going to tone down the music just a little bit more. It's a little overpowering, at least to me. Hopefully it's not too loud on the stream. I'm gonna turn down the overall general volume as well. So, that's not what I wanted to do. Apologize. I briefly started earlier just to make sure the game was working. I'm going to start over from scratch, so don't feel like I'm skipping anything. So, yeah, let's go ahead and kick things off and see what Deponia is all about. I'm actually really kind of excited. I've really enjoyed adventure games in the past, and so, you know, playing, like, in Machinarium, for any of you who haven't played it, it's a fantastic adventure game, and it's not terribly long. You can complete it in an evening, you know, 4 or 5 hours, if you're pretty good with puzzles. Now, some of the puzzles can be a little difficult, so you might, you know, there might be some instances where you're either, you know, really trying to work at it, try to figure things out, or you might end up having to look online for a solution. But you know, the game itself was actually a lot of fun to play, so I'm hoping that this game is like that. The same company that makes this game also made several other games. I'm trying to remember what that one is. I think it's The Next Big Thing or something along those lines. Anyway, so they've done a lot of adventure-style games. There's others from them that I believe I'll be playing in my series later on in the year, so just keep that in mind. You know, there's other thing, you know, they do several adventure games, and so if you enjoyed this one, I definitely encourage you to check out some of their other games. So I'm going to go ahead and jump in for a new game, and yes, I want to start a new game. It does give you an option for inventory mode, either scrolling your mouse wheel or clicking. I'm going to go ahead and do the scroll mouse wheel because that seems to be a little easier to use. And now, this game was originally released as a multi-part series. So you can see here, you know, kind of starts at 1, then goes to 4, and then on to 7. And so they've had a lot of changes overall. So right now, I'm going to obviously start at 1 because I've never played any of these games. But if you, for instance, played the first one and then wanted to pick up the complete story version, which is all three games put together, you don't have to start at the beginning. Like, it allows you to start at, you know, level, you know, or area 4 and then, or area 7 if you've played the first two games. So we'll jump right in.
Huh? What is it now? Wasn't the game supposed to have started already?
Yeah, well, yes. But the junk press broke down, and we thought we'd use the time for a little tutorial.
Who thought that? I don't need no stinking tutorials.
So how are you going to fix the junk press?
Just watch me and learn.
Maybe you want to listen to what I have to say first?
But you don't have anything to say.
Oh, come on. It won't be long. Just point the cursor at me and left click.
We'll see about that.
Alright, so I have not done the entire tutorial here, so I'm going to go ahead and walk through the tutorial, and that way, you know, you can also see, like, kind of the interactions in the game and the different controls and so forth, because it's not terribly, or at least I'm hoping it's not terribly long. It seemed to be going fairly quickly earlier when I was just testing things out.
Computer, talk to Wenzel.
You don't have to say that explicitly.
Who's talking to you?
Why, you are. You clicked on me.
Smarty pants. Just tell me what's wrong with the junk press. And stop wiggling your feet.
It's pressing only very gently now and doesn't really squish sufficiently.
Hey, every idiot can see that.
Well, why don't you present the tutorial then?
Okay, piece of cake. But first, I'll explain, how to talk to somebody.
You click on a character with the mouth icon.
Now you're completely wrong. I'm talking to you using the speech bubble icon. Everyone knows there's no mouth icon in this game, but there's a speech bubble icon to talk instead. Oh, and my favorite icon, the Rufus head icon for putting on, eating, and drinking things. If you can't even understand that, how am I ever going to be able to teach you how to look at an object?
I know that.
I see. And how?
I point my cursor at it and right-click when I see the eye icon.
Well, the theory is easy, but how about the actual practice?
Hey, this is your tutorial.
You're a cop-out, but be that as it may, I'll demonstrate. Do you see that little thingy on the floor over there? I will now use the tongue icon.
The eye icon.
Yeah, I will now click on it, thusly having a look at it. So you better watch closely.
All right, so as you can see here, he's talking about this object here on the ground. So as I hover it, you'll notice the icon changes. So if I left click, it would be the big gear, which is essentially to pick it up. And then the right the small gear in the top right is the eye. So if I right-click on it,
it's a cathode plunger.
Thanks for the input, Wenzel, but I recognize a hydro clamp duplexer when I see one. Too bad I can only look at it. A duplexer like that could be useful.
You can pick it up. You just have to point your cursor at it so the hand icon appears. If you left-click now, you'll pick it up.
There has to be an easier way.
If you say so.
Okay, I've picked up the duplexer, but what am I supposed to do with it now?
You put it into your inventory. That's where all the items go. You've picked up that object. Now you can open your inventory by using your mouse wheel.
So now if I scroll the mouse wheel...
Hey, there it is!
Then...
Correct! This is your inventory.
Yeah, I knew that.
It's where you can see what you're carrying around. You still know how to do that, don't you?
How did this strange thing end up in my inventory?
I have no idea. Maybe you'll need it for the tutorial.
Ah, tutorial schmutorial. I wanted to explain... how to use objects inside the inventory.
I click on them with the hand icon, thus making them my cursor. If I click on another object, now I'll combine the two.
Aw, how cute! I hope you won't exceed your limits if I ask you... how to end a...
You click on the last option in the options menu?
Ha! Completely wrong. Look, Wenzel, I'm almost done.
Impressive. But I mean that. I believe this belongs somewhere else.
I just wanted to see if you're paying attention. Huh, it fits.
Now you have to...
Hey, you don't have to spoon-feed me. I'll manage the rest.
If you say so. Rufus, there's one more thing.
I told you I'd manage without your help. Now, all I have to do is press this button here, and right away...
Oh, how I love tutorials!
It's kind of pathetic, you get all erratic about dirty dishes congesting the sink. I'm tired of your bothers, remember our fathers that dwelled in a world filled with rubbish and stink. But when all hope was lost, someone raised from the dust. He was handsome and cunning, his haircut had style. Courage was shining in his eyes as he said, screw you guys, mind your own business, I'm off now, goodbye.
Huzzah, he's off now, goodbye.
Junk. Junk. And more junk. A life of order and happiness. Oh, my bad. That was junk, too. Well, that does it. I need to leave this dump. Fortunately, this time my plan is foolproof. This time everything will work out. Where did I put my list? Heck, I really have to get away from this junkyard. It really is time I got out of here. Ah, there's my list. Let's see. Seems like I've packed almost everything I need. All I need now are some provisions. A toothbrush, a pair of socks, and a bolt cutter. A bolt cutter? What the... Well, guess I must have had a reason to put it on the list.
All right, so as you can see here, you point and click to move around the world, and as you can interact with things, it'll pop up here. And oh, what's this?
OK.
Okay, and here we are in the first room, right?
No, that's the director's commentary. I don't want that. I wonder if there's an option to... I thought I disabled that. Yeah, there we go. Okay, that's much better. Now that icon won't be in the top right, top left. Okay, so so as you can see here, I can go through and look around and interact with different things. So move over here and check out the old escape plan.
My old escape plans. Some of them weren't half bad.
Torch.
This could be useful. My father left me a trunk before he left me. I don't want to open it. I don't want to be disappointed yet again. My father left before he left. Oh, my father left me. Besides alone, was this stupid wooden trunk. Then he left Deponia without me. I can sleep when I'm dead, or if I survive and get confined to bed with bro. What's this? A sock? That explains why I've had such cheesy dreams.
No.
All I need now are some provisions, the bolt cut, a toothbrush, a pair of socks, and that's it.
All right, so go to the living area.
Locked. Tony must have the key. Another note from Tony. What's she complaining about now? Will you please clean the bathroom for once? Yeah, right. In her dreams. This could be useful. Tony says it's my turn to clean the bathroom. Now that's just unfair. It's never her turn. I've been waiting for weeks, and it's never her turn. Blech. What gnat's piss? Huh, it's seen better days for sure. Whoa! What the? The toothbrush bailed out on me. Guess I should have kept it in a more germ-free environment.
Ah, bolt cutters.
A bolt cutter is a pretty useless gadget if you think about it. I usually leave that stuff for Tony. I've only used it once. But all my clothes got discolored, and the shed burned down. Come on, brushy, brushy, brushy. Come to Papa. Aw, crap. I need a better plan to catch it. Why would I want to clean in there? It's dark anyway. This doesn't have to be cleaned. That's what I've been telling Tony for months. Nope. The corner once was a good hiding place, but that's the first place Tony will look. What? Whoa, what's that? A guillotine so I won't enter her room? Whoa, That girl has issues. I honestly wonder why we were ever together at all. Stay out of my room. You have no business in there. Who does Tony think she is? I've got better things to do than rummage through her drawers. You're not supposed to eat on the sofa. I keep finding leftovers in it. Huh? Well, isn't that a good thing? Huh, not a chance. The handle is missing and I can't get my fingers into the cracks. I don't see why I, of all people, should do the dishes. I mean, Tony has much more experience with it.
Oh, gosh.
Do the dishes. They won't do the... Oh, yeah? What? I don't see why I, of all people... I mean, Tony... This doesn't have to be clean. That's what I've been telling Tony. You scoffed all the food yet again, and I keep finding your crap in the fridge. What the hell's wrong with you? Huh? I don't understand the question. I'll have a quick look. See if I can find something. Hey, there really was something in there. A sock. Cool. Seems there are still some wasabi peas in there. But without something to put them into, I'm not collecting them. Ooh, cold. The good old soap. Too bad I can't. I've had them. Plus... but without something... The good old sofa. Too bad I've had them. Plus... No, I haven't finished packing yet. Well, those are two socks, but I need a pair. I don't want to show up in Elysium dressed like... Nope, it doesn't. Been there, done that. Adding oil to the flames is not bad. I need something flammable. No, I haven't finished packing. Come on, Brushy. Oh, I need a better... It's mocking me. Yeah? Well, just you wait. Nope. The corner won't... But that's the first place to... Nope. The corner once was... But that's the first... I doubt if I'll find anything appetizing. Phew. What gnat's piss? Locked. Tony must have the key. Ah, the first aid kit. But since the time I tried to build a shrapnel-propelled jet, the only thing in there now is Tony's tranquilizer. Nah, like always, there's only junk on. Blech. Nah. I wonder if I can find the second. And Tony keeps complaining that. What gnat's piss? Isn't there anything left to eat? Typical. Tony's working all day. But without. The mouse skedaddled long ago, which doesn't mean that its plan. Ouch! I'm not sticking my hand in. Nah, I don't think this'll. There's nothing left to kill. The mouse skedaddled, which doesn't.
Aha! I think I figured it out.
In you go! And Tony keeps complaining. But without something. Nothing to fork yet. If you don't do everything yourself. But without. I may not be an expert, but I'm sure I need a hot water. Pintoni keeps complaining. Ouch! Dad, that's hot! Come on, brushy brushy. Oh, crap. I need a better plan to... Pintoni keeps Whoa, look at that! The sock? Who would have thought it? But where's the other one? Clear case of subtractive color mixing. Pintoni keeps complaining that I don't... I wonder if I can find some provisions for my... The mouse, which doesn't... I think I can find a better... the fresh water supply. Let's get rid of this thing. I guess these will make... Pintoni keeps... This would make a fabulous... Nah, who needs fabulous? That's for... Now the little... Come on, brushy, brushy, brushy. Come to Papa. Ha! Gotcha! Ha! Gotcha! I'll make you suffer the next time I brush my teeth. It really is time. No, I haven't finished packing.
Oh, I guess I gotta put it all in the suitcase.
Toothbrush. Check. Bolt cutter, for whatever reason. Check. Provisions. Socks. Ha! Seems like... Oh, I can't close... Oh, seems like I've got to unpack... But what? It doesn't take that much space. It doesn't take that much. I'll never be able to close the suitcase with... I mean, I won't need a bolt cut. I wonder why it was on the list in the... Now it fits. Packed and... Ah, I think I just strained something.
Hey, Rufus, you should save your energy for the unavoidable drop into the abyss.
Yeah, thanks, Wenzel. You can save your sarcasm for someone less well-prepared than me. This time, I took everything into account. It'll be a stroll in the park.
Ah, that's what you said last time. It took us days to remove the cactus spikes from your butt, remember?
That's all toxic runoff under the bridge. This time, everything will work out. And when finally an Elysian Orbit Pixie massages my back, I'll ask her to pause for a minute so I can laugh about you.
Whatever. But say, can I have your stuff when you're gone?
Yeah, sure, help yourself.
As if anything on this dump is valuable.
It's time for me to leave all this behind.
Great. I hope you remembered to calibrate the harpoon.
I'll do that later, after I've stored everything in the pod.
Well, then, well, you know that the Organon are always on time.
There. Now... The storage space is closed. I gotta make room for my luggage, son. There. And now? There we go. I just got that from... it won't fit in here. If I remove this, but how's it gonna be attached? And more importantly... I'd rather not. There. Now. The cable isn't long enough. I just got that. And a sensor. I've been working on this for... It must have been since Monday. I just got that. I'd rather not. This will be the most spectacular departure ever. I'll have to prepare the escape. I want to be better prepared. I just need to prepare my escape pod for launch, adjust the harpoon, light the fuse, and then the rockets will shoot a powerful electromagnet toward a passing Organon cruiser. The escape pod is connected to that very powerful electromagnet via a... Once the magnet is attached to the Organon cruiser, I can reel in the chain with a pedal-operated winch system and pull myself and the pod up. Then, the cruiser will bring me directly to Elysium. This time, nothing.
Yeah, right.
Trusty Wenzel. I wonder how he's gonna cope with... I should send him a postcard. Hey, Wenzel. Still stuck in no man's land? Yeah, something along... Nope. Oh, crap. It's... I might be able to do without this. But how's it gonna be attached? And more importantly... But how's it gonna be... And more important... This isn't much use now. This isn't much use. This isn't much use. Hey, Wenzel.
What's up?
About the plan.
Are there any problems?
Problems? No, no. The plan is perfect. Where shall I put the...
Couldn't you have thought of building a compartment or something?
I had other things on my mind.
You slept through the whole afternoon while I assembled the telescope.
Well, I have to feel rested when I...
Of course. Anything else?
No problem.
Of course.
I'll go...
You better do that. You haven't got much time.
I'll have to prepare the escape. I want to be better. But how's it going to be? And more important. That's where the seat was attached. I'll need some kind of replacement. I don't. Ouch!
Hot!
Tony always had weird taste. Hello, Hannick.
Hey,
Rufus?
Ah! I'm really
Did you see Tony and...
Tony?
Big, angry, breathe, my former girlfriend.
Ah! Tony! Well, I guess she's down in her store, working, like everybody else. Except you.
Is the tunnel?
Yes, we had another collapse in Sector 7.
Another junk slide? All this trash is really driving me nuts. I'm glad I'll be gone for...
Are you?
You bet.
Well, I only know you won't be leaving through this tunnel.
I'll find...
This
time, it's...
Yeah, that's right. You being a fool and all. But I reckon you running around here has got nothing to do with any other problems.
No, it hasn't.
Well...
All right.
You going?
Nope. Oh, crap. A saddle-shaped... A classic.
Huh. I have to say, I really like the art style in this game. I think the the animations and just general aesthetics of everything is really kind of cool. I like it. All right, so now I think I know what we need to do. Mailbox, put it here.
Ha.
Mailbox.
Ha! There you... There! The cap... Now, all I have to do...
Aha!
There. Too bad the two directions of the control stick are blocked, but who needs those anyway? The main thing is that the crosshairs are right on the tracks. And then, I'm gone. Ha! This'll be a walk in the park. Did it! Now, I'll just light the fuse, and boom! Well, that should be it. Stand by, Wenzel. Ah!
Hello, Rufus.
Tony, why are you sneaking around like that?
This is still my house, remember? Well, it's not as obvious now since someone stole my mailbox. Oh, that reminds me. I'm supposed to give you this letter.
A letter?
Well, it's almost time.
Yes, I know. Sorry, Tony, but once the fuse is lit, I'll be gone.
If only that was true.
I bet now
you... That's right. Starting with, you can stay with me.
There's nothing-
What a stroke of luck! That means I can't say anything wrong-
No, it's too late. You can beg all-
Can I have that in writing?
Why are you here? Are you still hoping-
It would be a miracle if you finally- But in case it doesn't work out again, I'll at least have the satisfaction of seeing you injure yourself.
This is the-
It's too early to jump for joy.
I'm leaving.
I gave up hope of that.
Do I see? We can wait for that. I better not touch this. It's all set up. Now is when it... Hullabaloo. Ah, well, maybe I should read the letter. Dear Mr. We're happy to inform you, blah, blah, blah. Get to the point, will ya? Unfortunately, the delivery of your screws will be delayed for... Please find enclosed a voucher for a pack of rivets. We apologize for any inconvenience this might have caused. Sincerely yours. Just a second. Screws? What a maneuver. Hey, my suitcase is here too. It must have got entangled. I'm getting dirt between my teeth already. I better leave it closed for now.
A well-oiled gearbox. Ouch! The wire's cutting into my... has anyone here got a bolt cutter? I'll save my telekinetic. The colors must have something to... I better leave it. There's a flood of trash behind shit. Reminds me. It already has plenty of... I'll never be able... Why? Those are... Hey! Aggressive little...
Yeah, as long as it's active, I'll never be able to...
Not a chance. I need fingers like Wednesday. The maintenance arm's behind there. Not a chance. I need Hey! Not a chance. I bust my...
Why can't I get the toothbrush?
You don't play unless it's... Save my tele... I'll save my tele... Not a chance. I bust my... I need finger.
What else can I interact with? I don't see anything else.
There's a flood of trash. Reminds me of. Yeah, I better leave it closed.
I don't get what I'm doing wrong here.
A well-oiled...
I better... the arm is removing the nuts from... Well, look at those shiny little... the arm... I guess somewhere... the arm is removing the nuts from the gearbox. Well, look at those shiny little teeth. Ouch! I'm not... I need a bolt. I'll save my telekinet. Yeah, I better leave it. There's a flood of traction. Reminds me of my ex-home.
I don't see anything else to interact with.
It already has plenty. Hey! Aggressive. As long as the hatch... I've got a foot in the door. Yeah, I better leave. I'll save my telekin. It's overqualified like me.
This is unbelievable. This is just impossible. I think...
Are you suffering from vertigo, Ms. Goal? You should have stayed in your cabin. It was foolish of you to go against my orders.
What? What's going on here, Bailiff? Did you know about all this? Just a minute. All of you knew about this, right?
The whole Organon is involved in this?
Did you really think you could just keep it a secret? Wait until Cletus hears about this.
But you won't be telling him anything about it. You will be a good girl and wait here until the Prime Controller arrives.
And then? What then? I am an Elysian, not one of his office clerks. How does he plan to assure my silence?
Just you wait, Ms. Goal. I don't want to ruin the surprise.
Holy smoke! A real orbit pixie! I bet you'll be pretty thankful once I've rescued her from the... Let's go! Woof! One step closer and... She's really hot. She really suits me. Nothing's happening. Nothing's happening. The cup... Take that!
No, don't!
What's that? Ah!
Oops, guess that was...
You damned... How dare you mess with the plan, men! So...
You need to catch me first, but I'm much too... First I'm here, and now... Here... Ouch! I was so close. But no, the minute I see a beautiful... Well, I guess that's just who I'm simply a die...
Interesting.
The windshield is incredible. Oh, there's a sign. Maybe the name? Sure. Well, that could spell... Oh, great. The rust bucket's dead, but the lock is still working. Lock. It can... Ah, Miss Hinkle lost... Well, I'm sure it'll turn. I mean, there wasn't much kerosene in the turbine, after all. Toro! Hey, I said... If anything, he seems even more... You have to be age 6. Oh, what's going on here? I haven't seen such a crowd in front of the town hall since, well, since the mayor wanted to introduce a tax on the lack of political commitment.
Please form a line, people.
Draw a waiting number, and the mayor will see you in a short while.
What's going on here? Did someone refill the peanut jar?
A girl fell from the sky. They say she's a real beauty. The mayor is about to decide who's going to give her shelter.
Yeah, well, I doubt he'll have a hard time to decide once he's heard my story. I saved that girl from the dark exchequer. I am responsible for her.
Nice try, buddy. But I've made up a good story, too. Mine even has a dragon in it. So move to the back of the line and draw a number like everyone else.
The mayor who will...
Low-tech thing, and someone has to nurse her back to...
I hope the mayor will... She could give me a hand in the mud pit. Ever since I cut my fingertips while scrubbing rust, I tend to get infected cuticles.
You want her to scrub rust? That's outrageous.
Why? What do you want the... Rufus?
Rufus!
Huh? Oh, what? The girl belongs...
That'll be determined.
Well, how do I get...
That's easy.
Take a number and stand at the end of the line.
Where's the girl now?
She's lying in the assembly hall. Dr. Gizmo is with her.
They say she's unconscious.
I hope she isn't.
So do I. So do I. It's not easy stacking exhaust pipes with broken arms.
Nice hats. Did I miss a trend or something?
The roofer switched to making hats because it hasn't rained for months.
I see. And I'm sure the trousers are from the guy who used to make tarps, right?
Hey, my wife made them for me.
Well, thanks for nothing. Couldn't you let... See, I'm in a bit of a...
I see.
Well, if that...
Do you want my chair?
Shall we get you something to drink while...
We could bake a cake for you.
Really? I like cactus cake, but no raisins. Thanks very much. And... Oh. I see. Crap. Now I'm hungry. I'll skedaddle. Hello, Lottie.
You too.
You too? Dear me, what a day.
Where's the girl?
Princess Sugar...
Yeah, Princess Sugar Bottom? Oh, she's lying around. Of course, I knew you came because...
It's always
a beautiful young girl.
Hussy!
Interesting.
I want to see them...
Everyone... Take a number and wait your turn.
How does this waiting...
Do I really have to explain that to you? Did you fall on your head as well?
Yes, actually, but I was able to roll with the punch.
Well, obviously you started...
Rolling too late!
That thing over there is the waiting number dispenser. You receive a waiting number, you just take one...
And then you wait until the number comes up!
Your number.
Hold your horses. Not so how am I supposed to take notes like that? Can you make an
It's your turn when
your number comes up!
No exceptions.
Not even for me?
Especially not!
I'll skedaddle.
Don't let the door...
Hardly ever saw such stupid hats. Hardly ever saw... Goal! I have to talk to her. She's gotta know who her savior is.
Rufus, do you have to snoop around here?
Hi, Inspector Gizmo.
That's Dr. Gizmo. As you know, I hold all three positions in this emergency station, and right now, I'm a doctor. And as a doctor, I have the right to ask, why are you bothering my patient?
She's an acquaintance of mine. I wanted to see how she's doing. Her name is Gold.
So, the Elysian is an acquaintance of yours, eh? Very funny. Well, as long as your lacking sense of reality doesn't keep me from doing my job, knock yourself out. Look after your acquaintance, but make it snappy.
What? Come on!
Enough daydreaming for today. My patient needs rest. Yeah. At least I guess that she needs rest. In order to know for sure, she would have to wake up first.
She's unconscious. What's wrong with her? What does she need?
To be more conscious, obviously. For further tests, she would have to be awake. Unfortunately, none of my remedies seem to work.
Well, how about some really strong coffee?
Ha! The coffee that can be of help here needs to be brewed.
Doesn't every coffee need to be brewed?
Yes, right, but...
Hey, not to worry, Dr. Gizmo. I have a plan.
Do the world a favor and spare us your plans, Rufus. Your wacky plans have never done anyone any good. Except that the mayor granted me a larger file cabinet for patients' histories.
How peacefully she sleeps. This calls for extra strong coffee. Gizmo is a doctor, police officer, and firefighter all at once. On his best days, he has to change professions every other second. The balloons seem to have been stored here for quite a while. I wonder what occasion they're in, and why my face is on some of them.
Stop right there! Where do you think?
I'll go to Elysium with Goal.
In that case, you're in the wrong place! This door leads to the mayor's office, and access is
strictly by numbers only! So draw a number or bugger off! Stop right there! The post
The post office is closed until further notice.
Until when?
Until the sign says that it's open!
But there's no clock there.
Very observant. And now...
Get away from that door!
Those notice boards are great. I mean, if it wasn't for them, I'd still have to search for magnets and... Shouldn't he be maintaining the sewer system and removing trash landslides? Gah, lazy bum. Hello, Hannick.
Oh, hey,
Rufus?
Exactly.
How exactly does that detonation plan of yours work?
Well, that's pretty exciting, actually.
Yeah, I doubt it.
The chief detonator uses magnets to mark the positions of the next three planned detonations. Then he rings a bell, and I give a signal to the miner who will on his part prepare the explosives in the mine shaft. And after that, we blow the thing up.
And then you start with the exciting part?
No. That's it, actually.
I knew it. Is that your parrot?
Yes, we use it to detect dangerous fumes in the mine shaft.
Oh, what do you do when that happens?
We get a new parrot.
I see. Did you hear about the woman from Elysium?
Yes, but I really don't care. I already have a woman I can send into the mine shaft. It's too narrow in there for two women.
Love must be such a wonderful thing. Why aren't you working?
You mean... why am I doing just the same as you? Because some joker removed the magnets from the detonation plan, that's why.
Hey, I am very busy, actually. I've been running around all day, getting things done, and, picking stuff up, and things like that.
Well, how about you find some new magnets for our detonation plan? Then we can finally continue work.
What exactly?
What do you think? We search for you. Most of the time, trash is just junk. And for instance, I have a whole collection of car keys for car...
Maybe you have my key, too.
I don't know. What was your name again? Let me think. Wenzel. Nope.
Rufus?
Let me think. Rufus. Nope. I don't think I...
Tony?
Let me think. Tony. Nope. I don't...
Forget.
Done. Anything else? See you...
Rufus?
Exact.
Hello?
Hello! I'm starving! I've eaten nothing but worms for days now!
Ignore him. My wife sometimes talks to herself when she's down there. He must have picked that up from her.
We can't meet anymore. Although my husband is almost deaf, his bird has quite good ears.
Huh. This is a map of the trash tunnels. I'd better ask Hannick how this... Hello again.
Hey,
Rufus.
Exactly.
How does that...
Oh, The chief detonator uses magnets to mark the positions of the next three planets. Then he and I give a signal to the miner, who will on his part prepare the explosives in the mine shaft. And after that, we blow.
Right. That.
See you,
Rufus.
Exactly.
I thought you're on your way to Elysium. Have you come back to pay your tab?
Oh, that. Oh, well, listen, Lonzo. I planned to do that, but constructing an escape vehicle costs a lot, and,
Don't worry, Rufus. No one here expected you to make it.
Great. Thanks, I guess. Yeah, sure. As if it was even possible to hit that board with a dart. Lonzo. Did you hear about the stranger? The girl?
Yes, but I don't care. Don't tell me you want to start quarreling about her with all the other idiots.
Well, you know me. I'm always the first in line when...
idiots are quarreling.
Yes. Do you have something that can give someone a real boost?
Since when are you ordering coffee? Did you break Tony's coffee machine again? How often do I have to tell you that you don't filter oil that way?
No, this is not about simple coffee. I need something that really, really gets you awake. A kind of ultimate pick-me-up. Lonzo? Are you okay? Okay, just forget I ever asked. I'm off.
No, wait a minute. I think I know exactly what you need.
What the hell?
Oh boy. This is it. This is the moment I've been waiting for.
Hey. Wow. You have pipes? Tanks? Valves? It's a thing.
This is an espresso machine. But this is not just any old espresso machine. This is the mother of all espresso machines. I tuned it myself.
And you wound ribbons into its hair?
Indeed I did.
Okay, but one question remains. What exactly is this espresso?
Well, to be honest, I'm not sure myself. I think it's a kind of highly concentrated coffee. The people of prehistoric times drank it.
Uh-huh. And then they forgot to switch the machine off. I see.
I built the compressor, following all the instructions that I found. Unfortunately, the pictures were pretty blurry, but I think I figured out what ingredients are needed. Take the recipe. It's right next to you on that bar stool. If you bring me these ingredients, we can start brewing. In the meantime, I'll have found my life insurance policy. I hope. Ho 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 ho! I'm so excited!
What a scrawl. Okay, I need clear, reviving, and energy-rich water. The coffee powder must be black, stimulating, and made from hot beans. None of these things can be found in Kuvak. Never mind, though. Being a master improviser, I bet I can find plenty of alternatives. Gnat's piss. The only thing to drink on the planet. Not true. Luckily, I'm not susceptible to advertising. I could do with a steak now. The emergency station is opened again. Well, that must mean I can choose the more daring options now. Looks like Tony's in her store. If I go in now, her taunting remarks will shower down on me like a hailstorm. Well, what the heck. Let's get this over with.
Well, well, well. Look who's back. If it isn't Evil Knievel, the man who defied gravity, the conqueror of the sky, the wind jockey, the traveler on his way to the upper spheres. And yet, here he stands, right in front of me. Who'd have thought?
Believe it or not, this time I really made it. I was on board an Organon cruiser. Its destination, Elysium.
And then the longing for me became too much to bear.
I had to choose a life of eternal bliss, which means far away from you, or saving a beautiful Elysian girl from a horrible death.
Yeah, right. Rufus is doing a selfless deed. I would love to laugh, but my belly's still aching from when you were dragged through the junk.
I'll show you. I'll wake the girl, and she'll take me to Elysium. And then you'll be sorry. You'll all be sorry. What are those vouchers?
They're gift vouchers. You hand them in at the post office, and they deliver the merchandise.
Cool. I'll take them.
Hey, hands off!
What?
They don't come free.
I thought they were gift vouchers.
Ugh!
The first aid cabinet is locked.
What? Did you injure yourself again?
Not yet.
Too bad. You know what? Tell me when you have. I'll have a good long laugh, and then I'll give you the key.
You wouldn't have some coffee somewhere around here, would you?
Since you've been staying with me, I've only had decaf. And even that is too strong. Maybe I should finally get rid of the coffee grinder. It's just using up space, like you.
I've got to go.
But here you stop.
Weights, anchors, metal boots, hooks, all the things you need if you want to stay moored forever. There isn't even one crumb left. Seems like I have to find my own ingredients. Weights, anchors, all the things.
This is Wenzel's house. He'll be flabbergasted when he hears about my... I bet he'll be pretty disgruntled, because he decided not... He'll start shaking. And why am I not as cool? I also want to experience... But deep down in his heart, he knows that he just isn't cut out for this. He'll get seriously depressed. Oh boy, I really hope he's home. Wenzel!
Hey, Rufus.
Back already? That was really fast this time.
Yeah. This time, I almost made it. Unfortunately, like so often, my human kindness got in my own way.
Of course. That darn human kindness of yours. It's always getting into your way, right?
Indeed.
You never get anything done anymore.
Well, there are just too many humans.
They should all be...
drowned in the Red Rust Sea. Exactly.
That darn human kindness. By the way, thanks for all your stuff.
What? Wait, isn't that my chest?
Well, you said I could have your stuff if your plan works out.
But...
And your plan did work out. You just said so yourself, didn't you?
Yes, but...
Well, that's settled then.
Have you heard about that woman from Elysium?
Who hasn't? This wouldn't have anything to do with you, by any chance.
Hey, you know me. Wherever the woman that needs rescuing, I'm there.
You're right. There really does seem to be a connection.
I was there when the girl fell from the sky.
It's all right. I'm sure it was just an accident.
No, you're getting this all wrong. I saved her.
Of course you did.
Don't you want to go to the town hall?
To apply for giving shelter to the Elysian woman? The thought has crossed my mind. I even got a waiting number, but then I thought, what have I got to offer?
Yeah, nothing.
If I were rich or found a water vein, I might have a chance, but like this.
By the way, you're holding up the line.
So what? As long as I haven't found a water vein, I don't even have to show up.
How the hell did you manage to open the trunk?
Well, all you have to do is disengage the childproof lock.
That's my father's divining rod.
You think so? Legend has it that it always brought him luck. He found the water vein Kuvak's built on with this very rod.
Yeah? Well, if my father really always had that much luck, then why didn't he manage to take me along when he left Deponia?
I haven't the slightest idea.
Hey, maybe you can find water with the divining rod.
And where, pray tell, would I start to look? In my basement? I should say that's highly improbable.
Maybe you can help me organize a few things.
Again? You haven't even returned my lawnmower yet.
Oh, yes, the lawnmower. You'd better get a new one. The old one had lousy aerodynamics.
What is it this time?
Do you have any idea where I can get energy-rich water?
Energy-rich water? What's that supposed to be? The only energy I know of is in the car batteries you find in the trash heaps everywhere.
Yeah, well, I should have guessed that you can't give much useful information concerning energy, lazy bum. I think I'd better... Let's be honest. You were never a...
Whatever you say.
Never a big help. Brilliant.
What?
You don't get it? Not a big help. Because you're small.
Wow. This guy needs help.
Later.
Exactly. Don't even think about it, Rufus. It's mine now.
But it's a family heirloom.
So? A gift is a gift. Boy, I can hardly wait to give it a try. Maybe I can find a well somewhere near. And once I'm rich...
We'll split 50-50.
I might lend you the rod for a couple of hours. Don't even think it's...
But it's
so? Boy, me and one...
We'll split...
If my impeccable sense of orientation doesn't fail me, I should be under the shower right now.
Alright, well, since it's obviously going to take me a bit of time to figure out the next few steps that I need to do, I'm going to go ahead and wrap things up here. As you can see, you know, a game like this, I mean, you have to be kind of in the mood to play it. It's, you know, a little slower pace, it's not a lot of action and so forth, so a lot of story elements, a lot of just kind of figuring out where stuff is and, you know, what to do next. But I don't know, I've always enjoyed games like this, you know, it's just kind of fun to play, especially, you know, when you're just looking to, you know, do something kind of casual, just, you know, relax for the evening, you know, enjoy, you know, the humor and story and so forth. So, you know, if this is your thing, I'd definitely recommend this. I think it's a terrific adventure game, you know, a lot of good puzzle elements to it. So far, it's had some really interesting... you know, just different, you know, repurposing of, you know, junk essentially in the game to, you know, find what you need to do. And, you know, sometimes, you know, like for instance, when I was up on the machine, you know, it was hard to, you know, there for a second, there was actually kind of stumped. I was like, I'm not sure what to do. And then, you know, you start realizing, oh, wait, there's one more thing that I wasn't paying attention to. And so you need to, you know, just kind of look around the level as you're doing stuff and you'll kind of figure it out. So. But, you know, so I hope you've enjoyed Deponia. I think it's a really good adventure game. I'm actually interested in playing some more and, you know, seeing how the game turns out. So if this is your thing, definitely check it out. I think the art style and the music, especially in the game, I think it all really meshes well with everything. So, anyways... as always, you know, feel free to join me. I'm going to be doing this every Monday and Wednesday at 7 p.m., Fridays at 2 p.m. This Friday, I'm going to be playing Cube, or Quick Understanding of Block Extrusion, which is a first-person puzzle game. That one should be a little more little more action and so forth in this game. So hopefully that one won't be... It might, you know, I understand that this one was probably a little boring at times with me just kind of wandering around trying to figure out what to do, but... you know, so I think that one will be much more engaging. So I'm looking forward to that. And, you know, as always, feel free to check us out on the forums, forums.spacepotatoes.com. We're going to be doing regularly scheduled game night every Friday. This week we're going to be playing Demigod. It's a fantastic game. It's a MOBA style, you know, kind of like League of Legends or Dota. It's one of the earlier ones. So it doesn't have anywhere near the number of heroes, but it has multiple levels, which I've always thought was... I've always felt like is lacking in, you know, stuff like League of Legends and Dota. Like, I mean, you always end up just playing the same map over and over and over again, or maybe, you know, same two maps, you know, if you decide to play different, you know, gameplay style and so forth. But you know, with Demigod, they had multiple maps, you know, capable of doing the same thing, multiple different games, game modes on the same maps, or on all those maps. So definitely check that out. It's a lot of fun. It's, you know, it's not terribly popular anymore, so, it's fairly cheap to pick up. You're bound to be able to pick it up on Steam for, you know, probably $5 or $10, especially on a sale. And but, you know, feel free to join us for that. I'll definitely be streaming that on Friday, so you'll get a chance to see some of the gameplay live, and of course some of the other guys from Space Potatoes will be joining me and be able to comment and so forth. So hopefully you've enjoyed this. You know, again, join me on Friday for Cube, and this is Zero Guardian signing off. Talk to you later.